Poland took on Russia in the team final in Tallinn earlier in the season. Renata Napik-Miazga, Alessandra Zamachowska and Ewa Czesbinska began for Poland, with Barbara Rutz in reserve. Whilst Russia started with Tatiana Andrushina, Violeta Kolobova and Anastasia Soldatova, Tatiana Gudkova started from the bench. The start of the match was tight, with Czesbinska and Soldatova coming through the first leg 3 apiece. By the end of the third, Andrushina edged Russia into the lead, but only just. It was much of the same in the middle of the match. Poland did edge ahead, but the two teams went into the crucial final 3 legs, tied at 29 apiece. Karim Bashir takes us through the closing stages.
Napik-Miazga playing a containment game and skipping out of distance. Just avoiding the attack, and then second time of asking, lands her responding attack. And this is where a lead is so crucial. And the key thing here is Andrushina shouldn't try and give anything away. She doesn't want to take any unnecessary risks. Loses her weapon. That hit will not stand. That hit will not stand. The weapon of Andrushina came apart in the beat. Poles have asked for a video review. Yeah, so, and I think that's a fair call from Vanessa Chichon. In the clash of blades, Andrushina lost her weapon, and that is the reason the referee called halt. So even though the hit came very quickly afterwards, and you could even argue that it came within one fencing action, there was no way that Andrushina could defend herself as her weapon was on the floor. The response from Napik-Miazga is to score another single light. Getting caught up, and in close quarters, it's Zamachowska, the taller fencer, who gets us to the target score for the first time in 6 legs.
Two good bouts for Poland, but Kolobova anchored for Russia, having taken the individual silver medal the day before.
I wonder how quickly Kolobova's going to come out for this 9th and final leg. Surprisingly, Czesbinska falling into the trap. The Russian left her a little opening and she took the bait. A lot of us closed the gap by 1. Attacking from way too far away that time over Czesbinska. So on the back line, Kolobova decided to go for a beat attack, knocks the blade out of the way, 2 disengages, and that gave Czesbinska the time to land the counter action. This time a parry riposte landing for the pole. Kolobova's not done though. And another one back from the Russian. Plenty of time as well. Getting a shout from the team there, Czesbinska. As she hit the back line, Kolobova's got back to within 1, and there is still 50 seconds left in this fight. on the back line now, pinned to it. Kolobova seems reluctant to go for the attack, so Chybinska goes after her, gets the double she needs to take Poland to the gold medal here at the first World Cup of the 2019-20 season.
An incredibly tight finish, but Poland claimed the team gold as Kolobova moved on from Tallinn with two silver medals. Join us next time as we look back at the team bronze medal match in Bonn.